With me on the line now is Catalin Chiloflischi, Chief Executive of Canarc Resource Corporation. Good morning, how are you doing?
Good morning, good, I'm doing very well. How are you doing?
Very good, Catalin, thank you. Look, I know recent bit of news here. You've recently hired an experienced gold explorer as your US exploration manager. This is all part of the plan to step up development of your Nevada assets, is it?
That's absolutely correct. I mean, Canarc is a very unique company. You know, Canarc is probably one of the strongest juniors in the $20 million market cap. You know, we are sitting on a very healthy balance sheet of about $8 million cash. We have no debt. And we've recently acquired a portfolio of 10 projects in Nevada, one of which has a significant gold existing resource of about 1 million ounces of gold. And we are quite excited about the future going forward. You know, Canarc, I think, is now positioned to really become, hopefully, one of those good success stories as we are focused through the recent efforts in Nevada to hopefully make a new discovery there next to the 1 million ounces already in the ground.
Well, you say you're excited about the future going forward. Tell me a bit more about what the 2017 work program will involve.
Yeah, 2017 work program will involve actually spending money on exploration. The first money will be spent on exploration will be in Nevada this year, aimed for probably early fall. We are working right now to fine-tune a drilling campaign there. The larger project of our portfolio, which has the current resource, has 12 targets identified on the property, and we will be prioritizing them, and we'll be looking to do a drilling campaign later this year. Now, that's not the only thing we are going to be doing. We also have a Canadian project that also has a 1 million ounce resource, and we have announced a few weeks ago a $500,000 drilling campaign that aimed at making also that project bigger. So, you know, we will be having a lot of news this year about drilling, and we're also actively looking still on M&A. So it's going to be a lot of news hopefully coming out of Canarc.
Busy times ahead. The project you were just talking about a moment ago, Catalin, is that also in Nevada or is that somewhere else?
No, the other projects, we have two areas that we are focused on. We have the Nevada projects, which is 10 of them, one of which has the biggest resource, and that would probably be our main target. Then we have a portfolio of BC projects. In British Columbia, we have two large projects. One is called Nipolaris, which we own 100%. That project has about 1 million ounce resource, and then the most recent acquisition there is a project that's called FG Gold, which also has about 1 million ounce of open pit resource, and we will be spending $500,000 drilling in BC on the FG Gold project this summer.
In terms of the strategy here, Catalin, you're looking to take these projects from exploration right through to production, are you?
We do definitely have the ability and the track record within our management team and our board to do that. You know, if you look at our management team and the board, everybody inside the company has a solid track record to bring projects from discovery, advanced exploration into production. Somewhere along those lines, you know, we may end up, maximizing the value, such as we did last year, for example. We have acquired a project in Mexico, which we paid about $1 million for. We've done a PE on it, we got it fully funded, fully permitted, and then just before putting it in production, we sold it for about $10.5 million within 9 months. So we've made a significant profit for shareholders, and that's actually the source of the cash that is now sitting in the company. So, you know, along those normal progressions of the projects, if there is significant value to be realized for shareholders, we'll be looking to do that. But bearing that, we have the ability to put it all into production.
And you'll be bringing partners in to help along the way?
Yeah, we do have the ability to raise capital. Myself, I've raised over $250 million in the last 5 years for various groups, including Canarc, that I work with. And we do have, the right partners for the right project. I think, you know, the money goes with the talent and with the management teams. And in my view, even though there is a tough time in mining to raise money, we have been able to raise money even during the last 3 years when very few people could raise money. So we are really focused on results here and creating value. And with that, you know, we are confident that we will be able to finance those projects and those milestones going forward.
And you mentioned you're looking at or not necessarily ruling out further project acquisitions. Is there any particular projects you're looking at the moment?
We are always looking. We always have at any given time number of CA signed and number of projects we are looking at. And we have been very active. If you look at our track record over the 18 months, we've done three major transactions, which includes the Mexican project I told you about, and there is the FG gold acquisition, and most recently the acquisition of the Nevada project. So we've been very active, and we are still active. I actually personally welcome this slowdown in the gold space that's still lingering, because it allows us to hopefully make more good price acquisition that could add significant value to our shareholders.
That's an interesting take. And it's gold and silver that you're predominantly interested in? You're not looking to cast the net any wider?
Well, we are really looking in the Americas. That's been our focus. What I mean by that is really U.S., Canada, and Mexico. That has been our focus. And we want to keep our focus there because that's where we feel comfortable and that's where we have the experience. So it's really the Americas that we're focused on.
So that's geographically, but in terms of the metals, it's just gold and silver that you're focused on.
In terms of the metal, preference is really gold and silver. However, we have been looking at some base metal projects as well, which would have copper and zinc. I think zinc is very interesting these days. It's very scarce. There's many zinc projects around. We have been looking at a few opportunities in the base metal space as well. But we want to maintain the focus on gold and silver as primary focus.
Absolutely. Look, certainly busy times ahead for you, Catalin. Really good to speak to you. Thanks very much for taking the time.
Excellent. Anytime, and pleasure to talk to you.